Greetings, Pokemon players! Okay, so basically once a week we're going to be updating you on shit that has happened during the week because some of these crazy stories are just fucking crazy. So guys, we're going to do like a whole series of like articles all put together, so let's just dive right into it. First thing that came out during the week is Pokemon Go's success benefits the Pokemon Company more than Nintendo. So you're probably all sitting there thinking, what the fuck, really? Like, everybody's thinking that Nintendo's going to be making a whole shitload of money out of this Pokemon Go craze. No, actually they're not. Basically what happens with Pokemon Go, there is three benefactors from the actual game. One of them is Pokemon Company, the other is Nintendo, and the other is Nautic, the guys that make the game. They've all got a 32% share or whatever it may be in the game. So basically Nintendo is only going to be making 32% off the money from Pokemon Go, and they've actually come out and admitted that Nintendo has advised to their investors not to expect a financial windfall from all this Pokemon Go madness. Now obviously they still haven't released figures as to let us know exactly how much they're making from it, and as a few of my mates said, 32% of a shit ton of money is still a shit ton of money. So it'd be interesting to find out how much Nintendo actually makes from this. But obviously their share price has gone up, so it must be doing something. However, you're probably wondering, okay, so if Pokemon's not making the money from this, who is? Well, believe it or not, Apple. Apple has made billions from Pokemon Go. They're the actual ones that are benefactoring from it the most. Apple stands to rake in $3 billion in revenue from Pokemon Go craze over the next 1 to 2 years. As the gamers buy Pokemon coins from its app store, Brokerage Nigam and Co. said. So guys, basically, as you may know, Apple actually makes 30% profit or 32% profit off the apps that they sell in the App Store. So every time someone buys a Pokemon Go or buys a Pokemon coins or anything like that from the App Store, obviously Apple is getting their 32%. That said, Apple is actually going to be the people that actually make probably the most amount of money out of anybody. Third story, guys, see how much you've walked with Pokemon Go. Yes, you can actually find out how far you've walked when it comes to Pokemon Go. And if you are probably going to have a heart attack. It is an easy way to find out. First of all, click on your avatar in the lower left corner of the game. And once your avatar scrolls up for a bit, you'll see the first line of medals. Click the very first medal, you see Jogger. And that will actually let you know exactly how far you've gone. Once that opens, you expect once that's open, you can exactly find how far you've walked, and that will actually let you know. So crazy, crazy, crazy. I'm going to check my stats after this video because I'm curious. Full story, guys. Saudi Arabian men arrested playing Pokemon Go at the airport. And this story is pretty nuts. So basically there were guys standing around playing Pokemon Go at the airport while they're probably, I presume, waiting for their flights. And the airport security and the airport police thought they were trying to take photos of a restricted zone, so they arrested the guys who were in their mid-20s. And on related news, the Council of Senior Scholars, the kingdom's highest religious body this week, renewed a 2001 fatwa, or a religious verdict, that consists or considers Pokemon Go a game, a form of gambling, which is apparently banned in Islam. So, I'm sorry guys, if you're, you're not allowed to play Pokemon Go. So, that said, sorry. Even though the game is not actually supposedly available in the area, the game is officially not available in Saudi Arabia, but many of the oil-rich companies are believed to have downloaded the app, according to media reports. So I'm not sure how they downloaded it. Maybe they flew out of the country or something. I'm not quite sure. But apparently they're downloading it and playing it anyway. Next story for you guys is a crazy thing this guy did to become the first Pokemon player. So a guy in the US is reportedly the first Pokemon player to collect all 142 Pokemon. Now, you're probably saying there's probably more than that. Yes, you're right, there is. There's 150-something Pokemon, 151 total, but only 142 of them are available in the United States. This guy would actually finish work at 6 o'clock at night, or 6 or 6.30 at night, and then go for an 8-hour walk around Manhattan collecting all the Pokemon. Now, he was being accused of being a cheater and a hacker, and everybody's claiming that he cheated to do this. However, the guy who did actually make the post on the Business Insider, he has actually said that he is actually a friend of his, and he was getting a lot of text messages from this guy saying, hey, I caught a rare Pokemon. So some people are saying that it is true, some people are saying it's not. But if you're interested, 6:30, Johnson tells the Business Insider that he would start walking around Manhattan and Brooklyn and search for Pokemon. Those trips could last for 8 hours at a time. He'll walk until he come home and pass out. His iPhone health app tells him he has walked an average of 8 miles a day in the 2 weeks that the game has come out. Some of the fire highlights from his game, he chose water type Squirtle as his first Pokemon because he didn't realize he had a choice. The very last Pokemon he needed for his collection was an Omastar, in which he evolved himself. The second to the last Pokemon Jordan needed was Pyrogon. Some of these names I might be mispronouncing. But guys, yeah, really good article. Obviously, all the links to these articles are in the description below, so feel free to check it out. On other news regarding Pokemon, guys, a man was actually tasered by police while playing Pokemon Go. So a man in Tampa was shot with police taser after refusing to leave the Ballast Point Park is known for a hotspot for Pokemon activity. It happened on Thursday, the 21st of July, at around 10:30 p.m. after police told about 140 or 150, depending on which report you believe, plenty of people to disband for trespassing past the 10 p.m. park closure time. Now, the person that was tasered, his name was actually David T. Mastro Bermuda. I might be mispronouncing that. He has been held on $2,250 bail. Guys, I have got the video here. It goes for about 45 seconds or 47 seconds. Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Personally, I think this is a little bit overkill. The guy was just playing Pokemon and they tasered him because he wouldn't leave the park. Let us know what you think in the comment section below, whether the police are right or wrong to do this. Let us know what you think. And to finish on a happy, laughing, fuck my life sort of moment, guys over in Bosnia are walking way too close to a minefield. I can't help but laugh about this. So Pokemon has become a cultural phenomenon across the world and players are playing it. Players are exploring cities, parks, forests, everywhere else they attempt to complete their Pokédex. Some players, however, have been taking a little exploration too far. Players in Bosnia have been wandering a bit too close for comfort to the minefields. So guys, over in Bosnia, obviously there's still a lot of minefields that are around. They haven't been fully deactivated yet. And apparently guys are exploring, trying to catch Pokemon, and are walking way too close to these minefields. Guys, when it says you're supposed to catch them all, it's not supposed to mean catch all the mines, okay? Just for the love of God, stay away from the minefields, guys. You see a great big sign with a skull and crossbones, generally, stay away! Apart from that, guys, obviously if there's any news I've missed regarding the Pokemon craze for the past week, feel free to hit us up in the comment section below. Just post those links because this is just getting ridiculous. Apart from that, gamers, obviously I'll try and hit you up next Sunday and we'll sort of keep an eye out for the week for Pokemon news. And apart from that, if this video has been helpful, please slap a like on it. If you're new to the channel, smack that subscribe button. And apart from that, gamers, I'll see you playing games. Have a great night and enjoy. Monkey plays Pokemon.